Howdy, fellas. This is Gaming Pebbles, and I'm here today with Arthur, the main character of Red Dead Redemption 2. Such a game crafted a great open world to explore, and this world includes a lot of geology. So in this video, we will talk about rivers and fluvial dynamics. There are several river types on Earth, which may be summarized in three main ones: straight, meandering, and braided. Now, of course, there are more types, but simplistically, these are the three most common ones, so they are the ones we'll talk about. Straight rivers are rivers which typically form in the headwaters of a river system. This is because they are usually located in mountains, where streams have steep slopes. This allows the river to erode the bedrock, leaving a characteristic V-shaped valley. Other features, such as waterfalls, for example, might be visible sometimes. Straight rivers generally evolve to more mature stages of a river, which are braided or meandering. This evolution reflects the ability of the river to transport sediment with a lower energy. So, well, let's see what Arthur finds if he walks down the valley. So first of all, we are leaving the V-shaped valley to a flatter surface. What this means is that the stream is not actively eroding the bedrock, but it is depositing sediment on the floodplain. For those who don't know, a floodplain is all this unconsolidated sediment deposited as a result of a river. Second of all, we see that the river is not straight anymore, but it develops some kind of bends, which is what we call meanders. Therefore, as we have seen, the straight river we saw in the mountains evolves into a meandering river. Meanders transport finer sediment such as mud and silt. The cool thing about meanders is that they move and evolve over time across the floodplain. Most of the erosion is located at the outside of the meanders, where velocity is the greatest, while in the inside the velocity is the lowest. This is very well seen in this fantastic meander that Arthur is looking at, where turbulence is located at the outer part of the meander. This area where erosion is active is referred as catbank, while the other one where coarse sediment is deposited is known as point bar. If we go down to one of these meanders, Arthur can fully experience this. Since erosion is stronger on the outer part of the meander, the deeper part of a channel is located there. When he goes inside the water, the river becomes deep quite soon, but as he walks to the inner bend, the channel becomes very shallow. At this moment, Arthur is halfway through the channel, but it isn't deep anymore, and this is because water velocity is very low at this part. Meanders migrate laterally to the outside of the bends without changing their shape much. In this meander, the continuous migration of the bends has left a narrow neck of land, which is about to create a new channel. When the meanders erode enough, they will create this new shorter channel called cutoff. Creating a cutoff will leave the old meander abandoned. This generates what we know as an Oxbow lake, which is no more than the remnants of old bends. Arthur, who is walking along the river, has seen that the main channel goes to the right, but there is some remnant water on the left, which is likely to be an Oxbow lake. As he follows the old abandoned channel, we see that there are pools of water of an old meander, and that at some point, he will find the river again. Since this is a video game, I have decided to give Arthur polymorphism superpowers to transform him into an eagle and summarize what a straight river and a meandering river are by using a much better perspective. And this is because actually some hidden features might not be as easy to see. As we said in the beginning, straight rivers are usually found at areas with high gradients, and form these V-shaped valleys. They have high energy, active erosion, and as you can see, their turbulence is quite high. As Eagle Arthur goes downstream, we can see that the floodplain and the meandering system appears. All of these are meanders, and we can actually observe the migration of the channels towards the outer bend, since water velocity is greater at the outside. This is leaving sediment and active deposition at the inside of the meander. It is even visible how vegetation has not colonized the inner of the meander yet. Furthermore, this is the old Oxbow lake we walked on earlier. The main channel goes around the right, but we know that it was originally where the Oxbow lake is now. Even more downstream, there are a ton of cool features hidden on the floodplain. This is the main active channel, and all of these are old channels as a result of river migration over the floodplain over time. And this is a meander about to create a cutoff. In the near future, a new channel that creates a shortcut will be created there. A meandering river evolution is so cool to observe. So for that reason, I am going to step down from the game for a second to show you a computer model of meander evolution. This is done with MeanderPy, a script made by Sylvester whose reference you have on the screen. I think it is just awesome and beautiful to see how these systems create such beautiful patterns by just migrating laterally and cutting through the meanders. So the last type of river we may find in nature is a braided river. These are a complex network of converging and diverging channels among gravel bars. These channels are formed when the sediment load of the river mainly consists of gravel or coarse sand. These are the gravel bars, so channels go around them. These rivers are wide, and the best examples are found on Arctic regions, where they are formed at the end of glaciers. So I gotta be honest, I had a hard time finding good examples of braided rivers in the game, so I will leave you in peace alongside with these fantastic examples of braided Arctic rivers. Have fun, and I'll see you in some other video.